Hello dear students, welcome back once again. So now we are going to discuss about transmission of liquid pressure. From our daily experiences, we all know that in case of flow of heat or air or liquid, they always flow from a high potential region to a low potential region. Heat always flows from a hot body to cold body. It means a body with high temperature to a body with low temperature, whereas air always flows from a region of high atmospheric pressure to a region of low atmospheric pressure, and water always flows from a high level region to a low level region. Why? Because to equalize the potential difference, heat always flows to equalize the temperature, air and water always flows to equalize the pressure difference. It means because physics always follow the law of equilibrium. Equal as the pressure difference or the temperature difference, it wants to maintain the equilibrium condition. So that's why they always flow from high potential level to low potential region. In the diagram, you can see there are two vessels, vessels A and vessels B, which contains both contains water. You can see the volume or size of the vessel or the container A is less than that of B. It means the total amount of volume contained in A is much less than that of B, but the height of the water or the height of the water column in vessel A is greater than that of B. Now if we connect these two vessels somehow, then obviously water will always flow, the direction of flow of water will be always from A to B, in spite of the fact that the volume of the vessel V is much greater than that of A. It means and total amount of volume of water in B is much greater than that of A. It doesn't depend on the shape or size of the vessel or the total amount of the liquid or the water. It only depends on the pressure, on the height. So since we all know that the pressure that a liquid inside a stationary liquid and above the, in case of a horizontal plane, the pressure on all the points in a horizontal plane are same. So here water always flows from A to B. Why? Because in A the pressure exerted by the liquid column is greater than that of B. So it means to equalize the pressure difference, water always flows from the high level region to low level region. Means here pressure difference arises only due to height difference. So since in case of inside a liquid that is on a horizontal surface, the pressure of liquid on all the points are same. So it means whatever be the pressure here, it will wants to reach here, transmitted here. Isn't it? So whatever be the pressure is increased, if any amount of change in the pressure on this side, it will equally change in this, on this vessel also. Isn't it? So it means it will always want to maintain its equilibrium. Height is greater, height is less, but it wants to maintain its balance. Whatever the increase in height, it means pressure will be more. So it wants to give that amount of pressure, supply that amount of pressure to keep the height same. Isn't it? Because it wants to maintain, create the same pressure. So that's why the height is going to decrease and its height is going to increase, because pressure, it wants to maintain the same pressure according to the properties of liquid pressure. Okay, so that's why the liquid always flows from A to B. So it means whatever be the pressure is exerted here, it will be transmitted equally in this direction. In case of a solid, what happens? Now if in any part, in case of a solid object, if we apply pressure on any part of a solid, it doesn't transmit it throughout its volume. Why? Because of its immense rigidity. If you apply pressure on any particular portion of solid, it generally confined on that particular area. It doesn't transmit it throughout its volume. Now if its rigidity is not too much, it only produces deformation. It is generally deformed. We can only create deformation in the solid object. It doesn't spread out throughout its all direction. But in case of any fluid, either liquid or gas, if we apply some amount of force, it cannot confine with that particular region. It generally transmitted throughout its entire volume. Okay. because of its less rigidity than that of solid. So it means whenever in case of a confined fluid, confined means whenever some gas or liquid is contained, confined inside a container, maybe vessel or cylinder. So if some amount of pressure is applied on any part of a confined liquid, any change on any point of a confined fluid, equal amount of pressure is changed in all points. Clear? So means if there is, in case of any confined fluid, if some amount of pressure is changed, if any change in pressure at any particular point, okay, since in case of a confined liquid, the pressure at the same level is same, at any point at the same horizontal level is same, so at any part, if there is any amount of change at any point, same amount of change in pressure occurs in case of all points. So based on this transmission of pressure in case of a liquid, the French scientist Pascal at first enunciated a law which is called after his name, the Pascal's law, which clearly states that in case of any confined fluid, liquid or gas, if some fluid is confined inside in any container, and if we apply some amount of pressure, so if pressure is exerted on any particular part, on any part of this confined fluid, that amount of pressure is equally transmitted in all directions. Equally means in undiminished, unaltered magnitude. Whatever be the change in the pressure, if we take some amount of confined fluid, gas or liquid, and if pressure is exerted, is applied on any part of the liquid, that exactly that magnitude of pressure is equally transmitted in all directions, like the flow of water from A to B. Okay, in all directions, and this transmitted pressure acts perpendicularly on the wall of the container in which that fluid is kept. Clear? This is called Pascal's law. Okay, and based on this Pascal's law, generally we will see the how the force is generally multiplied. So now applications of Pascal's law, the principle of multiplication of thrust or force. It means by applying at any part, okay, if we apply some amount of force on any small area or any small piston, generally we get a higher magnitude of force on the other side. It means by applying a small amount of input, we can get a greater output. We can overcome a larger resistive force. So from let's see the principle of multiplication of thrust or force. Okay, its practical example is hydraulic machine. Clear? So you can see there are two vessels, P and Q, both contains waters, they are internally connected. Here M is the small piston, okay, and N is the larger piston. Clear? And above the piston there are some suitable places to keep some weight. Clear? So the area of the piston, you can clearly see this is the smaller piston, the smaller vessel and the smaller piston to keep smaller weight, whereas you can see from the diagram this is the bigger piston with bigger weight and bigger area. Clear? So now we will see by applying of the principle of multiplication of force, okay, by the application of Pascal's law, how we can get a higher output by applying a small effort or small input. So in case of a small vessel or small piston, area of piston M is A1, okay, and the weight, the smaller weight is kept on its piston. So obviously whenever a small piston is applied on it and since it contains the fluid, that is suppose a liquid water, so obviously due to placing of this weight on the smallest piston M, it will exert some pressure in the downward direction. So the pressure on the piston M due to placing of the weight W1 in the downward direction, you can see, which is shown by the downward arrow. Piston M is obviously, pressure is force by unit area, so that is W1 by A1. Now according to Pascal's law of transmission of liquid or fluid, this pressure will equally transmitted in other direction, on the other side, with undiminished magnitude. It means the pressure on the piston M in the upward direction will be same. So the upward pressure, mind it, here in case of the pressure by placing, due to placing of the weight W1 on the piston M, the pressure will act in the downward direction. But when this pressure will be transmitted through the liquid, then it will exert an upward pressure. Very clear. Okay. So that's why upward pressure on piston N is equal to, obviously, suppose it's P2. So this P2 will be equal to P1. Since it is according to Pascal's law, the transmitted pressure will transmit this pressure itself. Equally transmitted in all directions. Equally means undiminished magnitude. No change in the magnitude. Whatever be the pressure here, same pressure will apply here. So it is obviously W1 by A1. Now, if the area of the piston, since piston will have some area, M1 will have A1. So the area of the piston N is A2. Then obviously the required upward thrust on A. We have got pressure. Now we need the total amount of force. Thrust. Thrust is equal to the total amount of force applied on the throughout the area. What is pressure? Now, in case of now, pressure of a liquid means, if we consider a particular point, if we consider a particular point inside a liquid, and if we assume, and if we assume a unit area around that point, then the force applied on that unit area perpendicularly is called liquid pressure. Clear? Not the thrust. Pressure will have already, that is the force per unit area. So what will be the pressure of any liquid? It means inside liquid, if we consider any unit area, okay, surrounding a point, around any point, if we consume, if you assume any point inside the liquid, and if we draw an unit area surrounding that point, then the force acts perpendicularly on that unit area is called liquid pressure. Whereas the thrust means the force acting perpendicularly over the entire plane, or the total area is called thrust. So thrust is equal to pressure into area. So P2 is equal to A2. What is P2? W1 by A1 into A2. So W1 into A2 by A1. Now see the magic. Now the required area. Okay. So now since it creates, since the pressure is acting in the upward direction, so it will push the piston previously keeping. Suppose in this condition there is no weight is placed like this. So since this pressure will equally transmitted and it will exert, it is exacting an upward thrust. So it means it will push the piston. So it will tend to open. It will strike, hit the piston, and it will push in the upward direction. So to keep the piston in its own position at rest, we need to place some weight. Suppose this is W2. So that's why the required weight placed on N to keep it at its own place. Clear? So that is W2. So W2 is equal to W1 into A2 by A1. Now, since obviously you can see from the diagram, this is the smaller piston, this is the bigger piston. So obviously, the surface area of this bigger piston will be greater than that of the smaller piston. So suppose W1, initial input weight, the input weight which we have kept on the smaller piston is 1 kg force. It may be 1 newton also. We have taken it, that is not unit. 1 kg weight, 1 kg force. Now A2 is 100 times A1, means if the surface area, the area of the piston, of the bigger piston, is 100 times the area of the smaller piston, then just see, what will be the total amount of resistive force we can overcome? W2 equals to W1 into A2 by 1. 1 into 100. 100 kg force. Look at the magic. On the smaller piston, we placed only weight of 1 kg force. Means by applying 1 kg force on the other side at the output, what did you get? What have you got? 100 kg force. It means by placing only a 1 kg weight, 1 kg force weight on the smaller piston, on the bigger piston, we can overcome, we can lift, isn't it? And 100 gram force, 100 kg force. You can see the thrust or the force is multiplied 100 times. So it is nothing but force. So here we get the force multiplier, it acts as a force multiplier, isn't it? Because force is multiplied by how much? 100 times. So on the smaller piston, we placed only a weight of 1 kg force. Then on the outer, the bigger piston, we are able, it enables us to lift or overcome a weight of 100 kg force. So if W1 is 5 kg force, it will be 500. Just imagine, So this, in this way, the force is multiplied. That's why this is called principle of multiplication of force or thrust. And this principle is generally used in hydraulic machine or hydraulic jack, hydraulic press, whatsoever, to lift up the huge heavy car. In that case, on a smaller piston, only a small force is applied, isn't it? By applying a small effort through our leg, isn't it? If you go to any showroom of bike, isn't it? Or any four-wheeler, you'll be able to see by applying a small effort, the car or the bike is generally lifted through a significant height. They don't need to apply a huge amount of force. By applying only a small kick, the car or the bike is lifted up to a significant height. So, what is the weight of the car or the bike? Immense, much more than the applied force. So, by applying a small effort, small input at the smaller piston, we can overcome a large resistive force, just like the weight of the car or any heavy object, through this principle of a multiplication force, which is the, what is the application? Application of Pascal's law. Clear? So, hydraulic press, hydraulic jack, all works on the same principle. Okay. So, hope you have understood.